Hey everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to be doing a practice geared towards self-love and acceptance. I hope that you enjoy. We will be starting in a reclined position on our mat, so go ahead and set yourself up and I will meet you there.
Relaxing, reclined position on our back. Try to really focus in on your body at this time. Pulling the shoulders down, the palms face up with the fingers just gently hanging out, maybe open. Your toes are out, heels slightly in. Allowing your body to melt into your mat. Do a mental scan of your body, noticing any tightness or any tension anywhere. Acknowledge your mind. Are you feeling a little frantic or scatterbrained? Are you able to really focus right now? Understanding where you are mentally and physically is important, especially as we do our yoga practice, knowing what you're bringing to your mat in this moment. Acknowledge it, accept it, and then let it go. Maybe you can set the intention that for this class, for this yoga session, you will love and accept yourself with whatever you bring to your mat today. Let's gently wiggle our toes. If your body's like mine, you may get a lot of creaks and pops. It's all good. Maybe you can wiggle your ankles, bringing a little bit of life back into them. The knees, the hips, the fingers, the wrists, shoulders, elbows. Bring your feet together, point your toes, then bring the arms overhead towards the top of your mat, stretching out as long as you can, reaching your hands forward and toes, I guess forward as well, in opposite directions. Arching your back a little, maybe wiggling your torso left and right, right and left. And relax. Let's bring ourselves into a fetal position. Either side you want, doesn't matter to me, whatever side feels best. Cradling our head with whichever arm is closest to the mat. The knees are bent. Melting into the mat for a few more breaths. Let's press ourselves up into a seated position, nice and slow. No need to rush, no need to move super fast here. Keep your eyes closed, coming into a comfortable cross-legged position, or your legs can be extended out in front of you if that feels better. We're going to bring the shoulders back, stack the shoulders in line with the hips, and try to sit tall, proud. Relaxing the face. Inhaling and exhaling through the nose. We're going to take the right hand to the left knee and do a gentle twist. Just keeping the shoulders down, twisting over that left knee, using the right hand to take you a little bit deeper by pressing away from the knee or into the knee, but your chest is pressing away. Come back to center and switch sides. Left hand gently takes the right knee and we twist. And we come back to center. Inhale, lift your arms up towards the sky. Reaching all the way up, lift your chin as well. As you exhale, bring your palms to cover your eyes. Keep your face relaxed, eyes are closed behind the palms, and your hands are just gently resting. Not too much pressure here. Drop your chin down towards your chest. Gently roll the right ear to the right shoulder. Chin to chest, and left ear to the left shoulder. Chin to chest. Slowly blink your eyes open while your chin and chest are connected. So eyes are opening behind the palms, offering a little bit of a barrier. The palms are offering a barrier before you open your eyes wide to your room. Gently relax and release the palms down. Your chin and chest are still connected. Your eyes are open. Lift your chin forward. Inhale, lift both arms all the way up. And as we exhale, go ahead and take your hands straight down to the front of your mat. Roll the weight into your knees. Walk the knees back so that they are stacked underneath your hips. Shoulders roll back, chin is forward, arch your spine, and exhale, round the back, chin to chest. Cat-cow. Inhale, we arch. And exhale, we round. When you are ready, come to a neutral position. Curl your toes, lift your knees away from your mat, and press back into down dog. Now while in down dog, make sure your index fingers and thumbs are pressing into the mat as much as your pinkies. Roll the shoulders out, heels towards the ground. Look forward at the top of your mat and slowly walk all the way in between your hands. Allow yourself to hang out here for a moment, giving yourself a little bit of love, a little bit of acknowledgement, noticing how your legs feel, your shoulders, your head. Let's bend our knees and roll the body all the way up. Keep your chin and chest connected, take it slow. No need to rush. Really allowing that back to stand tall and proud as you come to standing. Your shoulders stack in line with your hips and your head lifts last. Inhale, let's lift both arms towards the sky. And as we exhale, swan dive. So chin goes forward, chest goes forward, all the way down towards the ground. Hands maybe connect to your feet or the ground. Bend the knees, roll the body up, nice and slow. As you come into standing, we stand tall on our ground, on our mat. Inhale, we lift up, reach up, look up, and exhale, look forward, straight back, chin out. Keep the back straight as you drop all the way down into the forward fold, allowing your legs to stay straight here. Bend those knees and roll all the way up one more time. Shoulders back. Inhale, lift the arms. And as we exhale, let's bring ourselves just standing tall with the arms floating down, gazes forward. Feet gripping your mat, you are in mountain pose, palms face forward, fingertips are spread wide, shoulders down, chest up. Inhale, lift the arms. And exhale, hands to the heart, sit deep into a chair pose. Pull your knees back in line so that you can see your toes when you gaze down. Shoulders are down, away from the ears. Tuck your tailbone in and sit nice and deep in chair. So there's an invisible chair behind you. And just breathe here for a moment. Your thumbs are pressing into your chest gently. Maybe you can feel your heartbeat. Breathe, drop a little bit deeper in your sit bones if you can, and if you would like to. Self-love, practicing what feels good to your body, doing what feels good to your body, and then maybe pressing yourself forward a little bit more. Sometimes self-love is doing what your body needs, what you need. Sit a little bit deeper if you would like. Feel those ankles, the arch of the feet, those quads especially. And let's stand tall, straighten the legs. Inhale, lift your arms up. And as we exhale, swan dive all the way down towards the ground. Head is relaxed. Bend your knees and step the right foot back. Now, if you need to come down to right knee on the mat, do so. Otherwise, keep the knee lifted. And we don't want to drop too much of our weight into that right palm. So what I want you to do is try to just keep your fingertips barely touching your mat. We don't want too much flexion in the wrist here. Bring the left hand to the left knee. Stay right here. Notice how that quad is feeling, breathing to it. Sit low into your hips. So this really becomes almost a balance pose as well, because we're not supporting ourselves with that right hand. It's just there for a little bit of guidance. We're gonna lift the left arm all the way to the sky. So it becomes a balance pose and a strength building pose in that left leg. Look up and reach up as high as you can. Spread those fingertips wide, keep the hands active. Notice where your weight is. Are you starting to lean more to the right hand? If so, bring it back. Keep the weight on the legs right now.
Exhale, left hand comes down to the mat, and we're going to step that right foot in, about halfway. Drop the right heel down, straighten the left leg, and pull that left hip towards the back of your mat and bring the right hip forward. So square your hips. Keep that left leg straight. Hang out here. So both legs are straight, and we're just working on a nice pyramid pose, a gentle pyramid pose, but also a really good deep stretch in the legs. Look forward and step the right foot to the front of your mat. You can bend your knees, straighten the legs, bend the knees, straighten the legs. Bend both knees once again and step the left foot back. So left leg goes back quite a bit. Find your balance to start. And we want our fingertips, once again, barely on the ground. Really, we're pressing that right foot into the ground and the left toes, balls of the feet into the ground, into the mat. Left hand barely touches the mat. Right hand comes to your knee. Set yourself up first, finding your balance, keeping that right knee bent. Take the right arm to the sky. And you can also always keep the right hand on the knee if you would prefer. However, try to reach the hand up, gaze up, open your chest towards the right side of the room. Feel that right quad working. Make sure you're not dropping too much weight into the left fingertips or left palm. Bring that right hand down to the mat. Walk the left foot in about halfway on your mat. Straighten both legs, press the left heel down, and start to roll your shoulders away from the ears. Pull the right hip back, left hip forward. Square the hips. Challenge yourself by bringing your head down a little bit more. Try to keep the back straight. Try to keep both legs straight. Really feel that stretch and the right hamstring. Look forward and step the left foot to meet the right. Bend the knees if that feels good, and then straighten the legs. Bend the knees, straighten the legs. Bend the knees, straighten the legs. Bend the knees and roll the body all the way up, nice and slow. Shoulders go back, inhale the arms to the sky, and exhale, hands down. Left foot is planted on the mat. We're going to work on tree pose. So we're going to step that right foot out. I wasn't playing the toes, just getting myself set up. And then slide that right foot in. Now your right toes can still be on the mat if that is your tree today. There's no need to get the foot higher, especially if the balance feels off. If the balance is feeling strong, maybe you lift the foot and you bring 100% of your weight onto that left leg, left foot. If it doesn't though, there's no need. This is your practice, this is your self-love. So do what works for you. You can bring the foot above the knee or below the knee. However, try to veer away from dropping it on the knee. And the reason why is because we don't want to press too much weight on our knee and have it lock up or cause us any pain. So above or below the knee is best. It's always good to veer on the safe side in poses, especially if there is not a teacher or someone there to really correct the form. Pull the knee back, so right knee is pulled towards the back of your mat, and the hips are forward. So right hip is forward, left hip is forward, and that knee is back. Bring your hands to the heart and stand tall. We want to pull our navel in towards the spine. And relax your face in tree pose. Make sure you're breathing. Sometimes when we balance, we focus so much on the balance, we forget to breathe. So breathe. Now we're going to bring that right knee to our chest and bend the left knee. Keep the right foot lifted if you can. If you need to step the foot down, it's okay. Otherwise, step the right foot all the way back to our mat. Drop the right heel, open your hips, and then open the arms. Left arm is forward, right hand is back, and you're dropping into that left knee. Now, you may want to walk that foot forward like I am, and really sink nice and deep into that knee. Warrior two. Keep the right leg straight. Press the right heel into the mat, and right pinky toe into the mat. It's going to help you straighten that right leg. Let's drop the right hand down and lift that left arm overhead into reverse warrior. Come back into warrior two. Cartwheel the hands down to the ground and step the right foot forward to meet the left. Roll the body all the way up into standing. Shoulders down, inhale, lift your arms, and exhale, hands down. Step the left foot out as you shift your weight into the right leg. Bring that left foot in, find your balance, and if you want to keep the toes on the mat, that's cool. Otherwise, lift your leg as high as you would like. Remember, hips are forward, that knee is back, the navel in, chest is up, strong, proud tree pose. Showing yourself a little bit of love by commanding respect in your mat, by standing tall, planting your feet into the ground, rooting yourself, and breathing. Bring that knee forward. Find your balance and then try to bend the right knee and slowly take the left toes to the back of your mat. Drop that heel down, open your hips, and take your arms to opposite ends of the room. Right arm forward, left arm back, and sink deep into that right knee. Strong warrior two. Gazing forward over that right hand. Try to keep your arms in one line. So the shoulders are in one line. You don't want that left hand dropping down too low. Exhale, drop the left hand down and take the right arm overhead. Back into warrior two. Cartwheel the hands down to the mat and step the left foot forward to meet the right. Forward fold. Roll the body all the way up. Shoulders back,
Standing tall, arms to the sky. And exhale, swan dive down. Let's come down to a seated position on our mat. However you want to get there, it's cool with me. We're going to cross our legs, shoulders stack in line with the hips, hands come to the heart. Take a deep inhale through the nose, and exhale through the nose. Inhale, and exhale. As you inhale, bring your hands to your eyes. Once again, eyes are open behind the palms. And as you exhale, keep the palms on the eyes and just let out the air. Inhale. And exhale. Go ahead and keep your palms over your eyes and try to bring yourself into a reclined position as gently as you can, uncrossing your legs, laying down, eyes are still open, but with that barrier between your eyes and the room. So you are now back where we started, laying down, legs extended, shoulders relaxed. Close your eyes behind the palms and release your hands down. Bring that right knee to the chest for a moment. Left hand to the outside of the knee and drop that knee towards the left side of the room. You can extend that right arm in line with the shoulder, making a half T shape for a moment. And let's switch sides. So bring the right leg back, left hand, our left knee comes into the right hand and towards the right side of the room. And bring it back. Go ahead and take complete rest. Get yourself as comfortable as you can and try to stay here for 2 minutes, at least, maybe 5 if you can. Settling into your mat, melting, giving yourself this time, checking in with your body, noticing if you feel a little bit better than when you started, noticing how and where if you do. Giving love to your body for all of its work. I thank you for showing up. I thank you for being here. Stay as long as you need. Namaste.